I guess, can you just start by talking about your experiences of bullying and the impact that it's had on your life?
Well, to be fair, I mean, it went through my, you know, my childhood to my teens, you know, and early 20s. And it was something that I found that, you know, I had to keep silent about, because it was, you know, I couldn't really talk about it. And the only person I really kind of spoke to was my mum. And it was a hard time. It was mental and physical abuse. You know, I was beaten up for loving my classical singing, for being like an opera singer, and not conforming with others, and also the way I look, my teeth and things like that. And it's just, it's a shame that, you know, bullying goes on, and you know, people feel that they have to keep silent about it. It's something to be ashamed of and that they can't really talk about. I think that's why I'm here today, you know, supporting the Diana Award, because it's something that needs to be, you know, shared with everyone and spoken about, not kept in silence. The great work that these do to help children and kind of give them someone to talk to, someone that's kind of like, not like a counsellor, but someone that they can talk about their emotions, their feelings, and probably take them out of that situation and put them into a better environment. You know, I mean, the world needs spread. I don't feel there's a lot that goes on to kind of like address bullying yet in schools. I know that obviously they go around and do talks and things like that to make people aware, but as teachers, you know, are concerned, I don't think they do enough in schools, and that's why it goes on so much.
For young people going through it right now who feel like life isn't going to get any better, obviously your life has completely transformed. Can you just talk about that and how good things are for you now?
Yes, I mean, I went on Britain's Got Talent with very little confidence, and the lack of confidence was due to, you know, the bullying and you know, not feeling good enough to be able to stand up there and sing in front of, you know, thousands, millions of people on TV and do what I love doing. But, you know, I got to that point in my life where I thought, you know what, I need to do something, because I cannot live in a life that people are, you know, always beating you down. So I need to express myself and hopefully show people that, you know, you can do what you want, you can succeed in life, and that's kind of like what I've shown in the show. I mean, I got to second place, which was somewhere I never thought I would be. And it's just brilliant. My life has definitely changed because I stood up to those bullies and carried on singing and carried on my passion. And they didn't win, because I did at the end. I'm here right now and I'm supporting this, which is fantastic. And everyone can do it.
Just to end on a really happy note, why do you love classical music and where are we going to hear you next?
Oh my gosh. Well, you'll hear me today. And well, I love classical singing because it's something, it's like a release that I get. It's something so moving and romantic, and I don't know, it kind of takes me into a trance and just somewhere that I could forget about the bad people, forget about the things that are going on in my life, and enjoy. And it just completely takes you to another place. You don't have to think about daily life. And so you'll hear me probably next. My album that will be released on the 8th of October. September now, sorry, it's moved forward. And then on the Collabro tour, who were the winners of Britain's Got Talent, and very excited to be singing with them.